again, this is Dan. Let me start my presentation. A couple of weeks ago, I met a friend, an old friend. His name is Kate. He said he moved, his family is moving. He moved from living in a house, an ordinary house, to living in a condo. He said it's more convenient. But he also said that he needs to give up many things, like having dogs and his pets, having his birthday party at home. This giving up problem happens because of space problem. And this problem become bigger and bigger and bigger, especially for those who live in the city. That's why today, I and Dan, are going to tell you guys, introduce you guys about a product called Van and Brick. It is a rising furniture. Nowadays, many people say no when their friends say, hey, do you want to go to shopping with me? Because they want to go back home and do the cleaning. Because they think that they are living in a room or a house that exactly fits their body size. Some may say that they didn't clean the house by themselves, they used the cleaning service. But don't forget, you also need to pay for it. So why we need to waste all the time that we think that it's a precious thing? It is valuable and it is something that you can't replace if you use it already. And why you need to waste your money for the thing you call cleaning service if it doesn't help you much? And why you need to waste your space placing furniture that are space eaters? Isn't it better if you can save them, all of them, money, space, and time? You can use the time for grocery shopping with your friends. You can use your space for playing games like Wii or Xbox with your friend at home, or use it for your house or your dogs. And you don't need to pay for the cleaning service, of course. But the problem is how it is really works. This is the ordinary chair, the rising chair. It is called a rising chair. You can just heat it when you just use it, it will look like that. And when you just want to heat it, it will look like this. You can change from a chair, a wooden chair, to a piece of wood in just one step. And this is the collection of the rising furniture, which Robert called rising formula. The first one is rising chair, which you just saw it on the past slide. He said the first day he was creating this one, the day he is designing this, he didn't know what exactly this will come out and look like. He just want to have the wood itself create its own products. A couple of years later, he created a table, and he's thinking that he don't like a table with four legs. So he's trying to make a beam there, like a bamboo beam, and there he come up a table. And recently, he just made these two products. One is the side table, and another is a small rising chair. This is the all product in this line. So the next one, I will invite Dan to continue the presentation about the benefits.
And what are the benefits of the rising furniture? Well, firstly, it helps save space. For example, if you live in an apartment time out if you want to play games in your room, but there are desks and tables in the way. Or maybe if you want to do some exercising just in your room without going to the fitness, then you also want to do that inside your room. But because of all the furniture that are in the way, that is why the rising furniture is very helpful. You can just fold it and unfold it anytime and just keep it against the wall or maybe just put it into a cupboard. And it also helps save time. Imagine if when you're cleaning and then there is a desk or a chair in the way and you have to shift it across the room or maybe try to push it to the other side of the room, and it's going to be very difficult to do the cleaning. And also some of the desks and the chairs are really heavy and it's going to be hard to move it around. So the rising furniture will be very useful for this. And it is actually very simple, as how Jay mentioned that you can just change from one furniture into a flat surface wood in just a matter of seconds. And anyone can do it. Children can do it as well. It's very simple. And it is very unique. Even though there are many brands that try to make furniture that help save space. As you can see the one in the commercials by SB Design, they also try to make furniture that help save space, but it looks just like normal furniture. But for the rising furniture, it has a very unique design to it that makes it stand out, and once it's inside your home, it looks very nice as well. And the designer who made this possible is Robert Van Embeek. He is a Dutch designer. He is very interested in art and architectural design ever since he was a young boy. He has been studying about structures and technique of the natural world. He was really interested in the bone structure of human beings and animals, as well as the movement of plant. So one day he had a flat wooden surface, and he started to make incisions inside of them and try to see how the shape molds itself. But he said that even though how hard you try to shape something or mold something, it will always turn back to the flat surface which it originated from. So he tried to incorporate this idea into all of his designs. And this is a timeline about the designer himself as well as his business. In the year 2007 till 2010, he went to bachelor degree in Amsterdam. And in that year, in the year 2009, he came up with the idea that I mentioned before about making the incisions into the wooden surface. And then he also went to learn more about the physics and the mathematical tools to help improve his design. And then in the year 2012 is the year that the design actually got publicated. And in the year 2013 is the year that he started his own business called Van Embeek. And in this year, in 2014, he has joined many exhibitions as well as competitions, and he has won many awards for this. So he thought to himself, why just stop it now? Why just stop at making furniture? He tried to make something much bigger than just our ordinary furniture at home. He made sketches and designs for architectural, something much bigger than just furniture. He had this sketched out. It's called the Shift and Merge Pavilion. He thought that there is this square, a center in the middle of Amsterdam, and it's a center where every tourist and many citizens tread by every day. But it's just an empty space, so he thought that something must be done here. So he decided to make this. It was exactly the same as the furniture, and when you don't want to use it, it can just close away into a flat surface. But what is it? It's actually a stage that you can have outdoor performances. Artists can come and show their artwork, and also it can just be a meeting point, a place where tourists can come and take photos. He used aluminium and aluminium beams as well as hinges to make this possible. He also went on and tried to build something else, which is the bridge, which is a bridge with the same architectural design that tries to connect the two different buildings together. And not only does he make these two designs, he's also planning on making something more like a car park, but instead for bicycle, with the same idea. It's just a building that you can park your bike around it, idea of thinking outside the box, making this ordinary furniture that we see every day in our home to something that is very outstanding, something that we might want to buy, something that is very useful. So that is the reason why we chose the Rising Furniture